Here, I want to show you how to get really relevant keywords for your photos or other images. Now, if you're doing stock photography, then this is necessary. Or if you've got a library of photos and you want them organized, then you want to do this. And it's really important to get accurate words for your images. And not too many, maybe 15 to 20 is what I aim for. If you just do too many that aren't relevant, and you upload them to stock websites, then you'll lose out because people will search those words. They won't find your image relevant and your image then will go down on the list. So the more relevant they are and more precise, the more people will choose them, and that keeps them at the top on the stock image websites. Now, there are three tools that are quite common to use. The first one is Bridge. This is by Adobe, and this is the one I use. You can just click here, and then over here you can fill in the data. And I fill in the title, the keywords, the description, and the author. And you can set this up. Automatically, this won't have these in here. You can go to Edit Preferences, and then under Metadata, you can choose these ones. File name, and then down here, document title, keywords, description, author. In Lightroom, if you go into the library, then you can add keywords over here. And if you don't have those two programs and you want to do it for free, then you can use a program called xnview, which is here. Just do a search xnview.com and you can download this software free. And then if you open it and go here onto one of the images, you select it here, go onto an image and Control I, and you can add a caption here, keywords and other stuff. That's how to do it. But what I'm trying to show you in this is how to actually find the relevant keywords. So let's go back to Bridge. And what I try and do is do these in bulk. So I've got lots of images that are very similar that I've taken. I've put on different effects so that they don't actually look all the same. And now I'm going to select actually a group of these and use the same keywords for them. And these are really for a spa. So let's go over to this tool, which is called MicroStock Keyword Tool. And it's microstockgroup.com tools keyword. I'll put a link to that below. Let's do a search for spa. You can choose how many images. I normally leave it at about 50, but I did do this before and a lot of the images weren't as relevant as I'd like. So I'm going to put this on 100, but start with 50. And then if you don't get enough images, you can put it to 100. Or if you get too many, you can put it 25. Let's click submit. And what it's done, it's gone to Shutterstock and found relevant images. And we just want to pick some that are really similar to our photo. If we look at the photos here, they're kind of spa products. So I'm going to pick some with spa products like these ones. Maybe 15 images is good enough. 10 to 20 images. We've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I think that's good enough. Maybe that one, 19 there. And I'll go down and submit. And what it's done, it's taken all of the words on those images and it's put the ones that appear most at the top here. So we'll find most of our words at the beginning. Let's click on some, so spa, and just pick the ones that really fit these images. So those are the images: spa, wellness, treatment, health, relaxation therapy, healthy, natural. Some people, when they're searching, they might search for a combination of these. They might search for relaxation therapy or natural health. So we want to just put words that they might search. And we're trying to get about 15 to 20 here. Luxury resort is okay. Skincare, day spa. Not sure about healthcare. It's more like wellness, really. Well-being. Body care. We can put some of the things. There were towels in it, so we could put towels. I'm not sure if someone's searching towels, maybe they don't really want this image. So I'm going to leave that. I'm not that familiar with the topic, whether aromatherapy. Not sure what that is. Wellness spa. Some of these are phrases, so they're quite good. It's good to go down to the bottom because you do still find some, like here, day spa. That's really relevant. And that's it. So I've got 20 words already. I click on it one time and it selects all of them. Control C, it copies them. And then I go back. And what I would do, I've done these already, so I'm not going to do it again, but I would just then select all of the ones where it's relevant, which is pretty much all of these. So I can do them all at the same time and then just click here and control V to copy them in there. And that's it. I've been doing it this way a long time and it is really quick. I try and do my images in batches and then I just select all of them and put in the keywords and I can do this very quickly. I have then got to make up a title and description and I just use the keywords in there anyway. So it helps me with the title and the description as well. I used to use Lightroom and it works slightly different that you can have, it's like hierarchies of words. So you might put beauty and you can put all the words associated with it. But I found that it gives a lot of words that are not relevant. Some words might be relevant for, you might have a picture of a face and under beauty you might say makeup. But then in another setting, like this spa, you might say beauty and makeup doesn't fit. So I don't really like the way that they do it in Lightroom, and I stopped using it.